regard to the prescribing of, say, minocycline or doxycycline, what if anything is the physician required to tell a patient in order to comply with the standard of care?
In terms of what we're using it for, again, you know, that it's for treatment of acne.
Okay, my question may have not been very properly phrased, I'm sorry. In prescribing an antibiotic like minocycline or doxycycline, does the standard of care require that you identify specific side effects that that medication may cause?
No, that's I guess all doctors have some different approach to it, but the approach I think that is commonly used in the community, certainly commonly used in our group, is when you prescribe not just antibiotics, but really any medication, whether it's for blood pressure, arthritis, or acne, what we do is that after prescribing medication is to tell the patient that any medication can cause any side effect. I can't predict what side effect might happen to you, but I want you to realize that if anything unusual happens to you, anything unusual, stop the medication and call or return, and we'll try to determine if it's some sort of adverse reaction.
So you don't go through and list anything specific, just to take the medication if you have any response to it you think is unusual.
Well, I can tell you that when I first started practice, which is now 30 plus years ago, I thought that the way to do that would be to try to list out the most common side effects that somebody might be expected to encounter. But I really quickly learned that patients will listen to that, and they'll sometimes wouldn't think that some other side effect that I didn't have in the list, because the list is really long for side effects of all medications, if you know, you go up to the patent inserts, they go on and on. So I realized that that wasn't a good strategy, because patients often thought that something that I didn't tell them about wasn't related to the drug that I just prescribed. So a long time ago, I adopted, which I think is the approach that most doctors use, is just say anything could happen. If anything happens that you think is unusual, you know your body better than anybody. If something's weird, let me know. That's the standard approach.
So the short answer to my question is you don't identify specific complications.
I don't, and I don't think it's the common way it's done.
In your experience, are there side effects to the use of minocycline or doxycycline?
Sure.
And what are the potential side effects of those medications to your knowledge?
Well, I would tell you the same thing, that there are any number of side effects that could occur if anything unusual happens. But well, antibiotics as a broad class can cause, you know, the usual and sundry type of things like upset stomach, rash. But then it goes on from there to any number of unusual and sometimes terrible side effects. All antibiotics, many medications do have some pretty severe side effects, even though they're commonly used.
Now, in looking at the pertinent visit of August 18, 2011, which is Exhibit 6-2, when the patient came in at this point for a skin problem for a year, you know from reviewing the records that she had previously used minocycline that was prescribed by Dr. Yu back in 2006, I believe.
Yes, I think 5 years or so prior to this visit.
And that she'd also gotten some doxycycline, I believe, from Dr. Kim as well.
Yes.
And as well from the dermatologist, Dr. Park.
Yes.
And you also know by that time that the patient had commented in the records from the Utah Health Center that the acne seemed to respond to the treatment. She was taking medication and she was off for a period of time and it would flare back up.
Yes.
Okay. Now, at this point in time, she presents on August 18, 2011. And in this instance, based upon the information you learned from reading the depositions and looking at the records,
you believe that it was appropriate for Dr. Yu to prescribe Cetra in this case?
DMD's override Bass Foundation.
Go ahead, you can answer. Overruled, you may answer.
I thought it was appropriate to prescribe Cetra or tell some of those doctors and some of the social class of drugs. It's one of three or four antibiotics that's in the next group of drugs that's typically used to treat acne. As we just discussed, the first line is doxycycline, minocycline. When those don't work, which happens, and it is happening a little bit more often these days, again, because of antibiotic resistance, but when doxy minocycline doesn't work, then you have a couple of things you can consider. But the list isn't very long. In terms of antibiotics, you can consider the sulfa drugs like Bactrim, etc., clindamycin, erythromycin, and Keflex. So there's only really about four. So that's the antibiotic class. Then the other, well, of course, you probably already talked about the topical treatments and topical retinoids like Retin-A and so forth. But then your other two choices are Accutane, which is the most potent anti-acne medication, but has a lot of side effects and a lot of toxicity. And I think that Nishimura did not want to take Accutane, as we've seen in the records. And then the other treatment option is oral contraceptives. Well, throw it in. It's oral contraceptives, and I think that she tried that and had some type of reaction that she did not want to be on contraceptives. So if you have a situation where a patient comes and isn't just asking for a simple refill of a medication that's currently working, if there's some indication, as I learned from Dr. Yu's deposition, that the doxycycline wasn't working, and that's why she came in to seek something that might be different and more effective, then your choices are those four antibiotics. The sulfas like Bactrim, clindamycin, Keflex, and erythromycin, that all of them have more toxicity, probably a little bit more toxicity than doxycycline and minocycline, and minocycline and doxycycline probably work a little bit better in general, so that's why I use those first. But those are the four that you choose from, and so it's not usual to choose Bactrim or Cetra. It's one of the normal drugs that's used for acne. It's not something that's unusual at all.